tonight on E Talk.
You're gonna win. I'm gonna win.
Dude, go away. It's gonna blow up.
Dude, the guys in there.
We have confirmed your DUA.
Gone too soon. Paul Walker loses his life in a devastating car crash.
I'm standing feet away from where the accident happened as authorities try to figure out what went wrong.
He was trapped. You could see him. I could see him.
The wreckage. The vigil. Hollywood reacts.
Wouldn't it be refreshing if they said, you know, in honor of him, we're not going to finish the movie?
Plus, E Talk's time with the star over the years.
I try to live life one day at a time.
And our final sit down.
What are some of your thoughts when you look at that picture?
I shouldn't have let him frost my hair. That's the first thing I think of.
Plus, our big Katy Perry exclusive.
Can you feel the love?
Yeah, I finally come back to Canada to share my prison with you.
Only we're with the superstar for every step of her Toronto takeover. And stay classy, Canada.
I'm really enjoying Winnipeg. The Paris of Canada, as it's known.
The Anchorman conquers Canada.
Let's see if this is curling history right here.
It's Monday, December 2nd. From our eTalk newsroom in the heart of downtown Toronto, with host Tanya Kim, Devin Soltendieck, Tracy Melchior, and reporting from Los Angeles, Ben Mulrooney. eTalk begins right now.
A Hollywood tragedy. Fast and Furious star Paul Walker dead at 40 after a horrific car crash. Now today, we are piecing together the final moments. Our coverage begins with Ben, who's standing by just outside of Los Angeles.
Thanks, DK. Well, as you can see, there has been a massive outpouring of grief at the crash site as this makeshift vigil continues to grow. The accident has left fans, family, and friends in shock, wondering just how something like this could have happened.
You're gonna win. I'm gonna win.
On the big screen, Paul Walker lived fast. 12 years after his breakout role, no one could have predicted this.
LA-156, front scene. We have one vehicle fully involved.
Amateur video taken moments after the crash paints a grim picture. The car barely recognizable, wrapped around a tree and engulfed in flames. Onlookers are powerless to help.
Dude, go away. It's gonna blow.
But that danger doesn't stop friends from rushing to the scene to try and save him.
We're trying with extinguishers to put out the flames. He was trapped. You could see him. I could see him.
This firsthand account from the scene is excruciating.
They were risking their lives trying to reach into the car and undo his seatbelt. And I had to grab him and we pulled each other off because we were all fighting, risking ourselves because it's something that he would have done.
By the time emergency personnel arrive, it's too late.
We have confirmed two DUA.
As workers remove the wreckage, the true scope of the incident becomes clear. Paul did not stand a chance. This photo, taken moments before the ill-fated trip, shows Paul posing proudly next to the red Porsche Carrera GT. This is all that's left of it after the crash.
Here at the crash site, you can see just how violent this accident was. Tire marks all over the road and an uprooted tree right behind me. Authorities are scrambling to figure out what went wrong.
When they crashed, they were only about 500 feet from the event.
Roger Rodas, the man behind the wheel, a professional driver and Walker's business partner.
Both the guys were high-performance race car drivers. They were both pros. They knew what they were doing. There was no drag racing involved.
Both men perished at the scene. The two so disfigured, the coroner is unable to identify their bodies without dental records. Their families are reportedly in shock.
Paul left behind his 15-year-old daughter, Meadow. She recently moved from Hawaii and was now living with Paul.
She's going to be with me this summer. She's going to be going into high school this next year. And that was, you know, a big debate. Do I want to be gone?
Today, Paul's father can barely keep composure.
I'm just glad every time I saw him, I told him I loved him. And he said the same thing to me.
By all accounts, Paul, too, was a very loving father and an all-around good person. Before Saturday's crash, Walker was doing charity work.
Authorities say speed was a factor, but today questions are being raised about the car and what role Walker's Fast and Furious ride could have played.
Be safe, drive smart, and stay legal.
This 2009 PSA now takes an ominous tone, but proves Paul was cognizant of car safety.
City streets and highways are no place for reckless behavior. So all of you behind the wheel, Remember, stunt driving belongs in the movies and not on the streets.
So, did this car pose a particular danger?
For you to get going fast enough to hit a lamppost and cause a car as strong as the Carrera GT to basically blow up, clearly a tragedy.
Fellow car enthusiasts on the scene suggest there may have been a steering fluid leak based on the trajectory of the car. But today, TMZ drops this bombshell headline, cops investigating possible street race.
Roger, who was driving the car, was clearly going way too fast.
A lot of questions, and so far, not very many answers. So for now, all friends and co-stars can do is wait and mourn.
Seen at the makeshift memorial, co-star Tyrese becomes visibly upset yesterday, breaking into tears. On Twitter, it's a massive outpouring. Jessica Alba, Ryan Phillippe, James Franco, Ludacris. His Canadian Flags of Our Fathers co-star, Adam Beach, also chimes in saying, quote, "All my love and respect to the Walker family. Paul was an amazing guy." Fast and Furious frontman Vin Diesel tweets, quote, "Brother, I will miss you very much. I am absolutely speechless." And Dwayne Johnson tweets this pic saying simply, quote, "Love you, brother."
But so far, not all reaction has been positive.
The producers think they can continue finishing, you know, Fast and Furious 7. Wouldn't it be refreshing if they said, you know, in honor of him, we're not going to finish the movie?
His last film, as it turns out, would be Brick Mansions, where E-Talk joined him on set in June.
You live the ride.
But for fans, Fast and Furious will always be Walker's best work.
Screw it.
These photos show Paul on set of the series' seventh installment, which has reportedly suspended filming after his death as the studio figures out how to cope with the loss.
The need for speed is nothing new in Hollywood, glorified in films like The Fast and the Furious, Night and Day, and more recently, Rush. And for some stars, it's become a real-life obsession.
I broke my spine and I shattered both my feet.
So I wasn't driving recklessly, I promise.
When you do well at the track, there's nothing more satisfying than that.
Hollywood's obsession with wheels is a billion-dollar business.
We drive the cars enough to understand the power of these machines and appreciate them and be a little scared at times.
Need for Speed, The Transporter, The Italian Job, Gone in 60 Seconds, and Drive.
I don't carry a gun. I drive.
And beyond the big screen, it's a passion for many.
Other celebrities have been in car crashes, whether or not they survived. From people from like James Dean to Jason Priestley, this car crash and this death is really significant because this is Paul Walker dying in a way that he portrayed a character on screen.
Tom Cruise races around with Red Bull and F1. Patrick Dempsey's love of speed has taken him to the grueling 24-hour of Le Mans race.
I want to be the racer who wins.
But pushing the limits has its consequences.
I ripped my nose off my face, and I broke my orbital bone, my cheekbone, and my ocular mantle.
In 2002, during a race, Jason Priestley hit a wall at nearly 180 miles per hour. And after almost being killed, Jason still races to this day.
I just do some stuff for fun, endurance racing and go-kart racing.
As the stars continue to be fascinated by speed, many racers have crossed over into the celebrity world.
I'm a big racing fan, so I like it.
Danica Patrick is a household name. She once drove for David Letterman's race team and has even starred in one of Jay-Z's music videos. Show me what you got, baby.
Hands up and wave. Later in the show, more Paul Walker. Tracy talks to us about her final interview with him. Plus, filming in Canada. We take you on set of his final movie, Brick Mansions. But for now, it's back to you, TK, in Toronto.
Thanks, Ben. All right, it has been a busy weekend here in Toronto with Katy Perry stopping by for a special concert and interview. And only our cameras are rolling for it all.
Can you feel the love?
Yeah, I finally come back to Canada to share my prison with you.
It's a teenage dream come true for Katy Perry fans who packed Toronto's Virgin Mobile Mod Club for an intimate concert.
Always been behind me from the very beginning. You guys really know how to support my music. You get behind it, you love it, it resonates with you, and you know, I really appreciate that.
Katy even pays tribute to one very special Toronto fan, Olivia Wise, who recently lost her battle with cancer.
Yeah, we should give a big scream for Olivia. She was an inspiration to me after seeing that video and hearing her story, and
seeing the positivity that she had and she held on to. I was just so blessed to be able to be a part of that in the smallest way, and having War be the soundtrack.
Prism is packed full of personal songs written shortly after her divorce from comedian Russell Brand. Including her latest Unconditionally, penned for new love John Mayer. I will love
you. It's a universal love song, but it's more than just about like the love in a relationship. It's a song about the highest level of love. You know, the love without fear. Unconditional love hopefully covers the fact that you can be loved for all that you are. Every weird thing, every great thing.
Tomorrow on the show.
Oh, you're in reflection section. Oh, you want to be in reflection section. Yes, you do.
Katie Talks, the Prismatic Tour.
It is a special section. When I announce my tour here in Canada, you want to look after. It's the closest seats.
Well, Ron Burgundy has been all over the media making his Canadian broadcasting debut in Winnipeg, and today, stepping out of character, talking Ford Nation with me.
I'm sure he'd be really good friends with a guy like Rob Ford.
Right.
Guy who likes to yuck it up.
A rare sight. Will Ferrell out of character promoting Anchorman 2, hitting theaters in 2 weeks. This follows a weekend of Ron Burgundy hijinks ringside in Winnipeg.
Which, of course, in Latin means...
Please. Uh-huh. We still want to work.
The beautiful hill country.
Thank you.
Dressed in his signature wine-colored pants, Ron sports a TSN jacket and arrives in all his Anchorman glory to the biggest curling event of the year.
Cavity search?
Well, that could come later.
Grabbing a donut on the way.
That's a good crawler, by the way.
Ron meets with fans and curlers before the games.
These things are useless.
And even shows off his skills on the ice, throwing a rock.
That's a damn good throw.
The Anchorman also holds court with the press.
I'm really enjoying Winnipeg. The Paris of Canada, as it's known.
And reminisces about his curling roots.
We used to do a curling segment on the news in San Diego. No one watched it.
Later, Ron trades slacks for a kilt and joins TSN's Vic Router in the broadcast booth where the two bury the hatchet.
Vic, I need to apologize to you.
Yes.
I said some slanderous things in the bumpers that I taped. And
yes.
I'm jealous of your ability and your upstanding position as a man, and I'm sorry for what I said about you.
After the break, one of Paul Walker's final roles.
Action's action.
And we dig into our eTalk vault.
What are some of your thoughts when you look at that picture? You guys all look great. Hair's changed.
I shouldn't have let him frost my hair. That's the first thing I think of.
That's coming up when eTalk returns.
Subway Restaurant Super Morning Squad is in hot pursuit of ways to ignite your hunger for the most important meal of the day. Add a bit of fiery flavor to your bacon, egg, and cheese sandwich. Try our new creamy sriracha sauce, or turn up the heat with some jalapenos. Catch a taste of our fiery breakfast sandwiches before they're gone. Subway, eat fresh.
The final six take center stage.
The absolute best performances ever.
But only four will move on.
Very, very great job. Tremendous job.
Who will stay?
There's nobody else that sounds quite like you.
Who will go?
You blew me away in rehearsals. This was 50 times more amazing.
The Voice, all new. Watch tonight at 8, 7 Central. Also on CTV.ca and the CTV Go app.
Closed captioning brought to you in part by Tim Horton's new gingerbread white hot chocolate or our gingerbread donut. Two of our many festive flavors available this holiday season.
Here at eTalk, we have followed Paul Walker's career very closely, going all the way back to his roles in Varsity Blues and The Skulls, most recently in the Fast and the Furious franchise. And for this story, Tracy is standing by in studio.
Ben, obviously this is such a tragedy. I'm a huge fan of his work, especially the Fast franchise. I've interviewed Paul several times, my last time being in May.
I have a little picture, show and tell. Look at that. Wow. 12 years ago.
Isn't that cool?
What are some of your thoughts when you look at that picture.
I shouldn't have let him frost my hair. That's the first thing I think of.
Frost and tip?
Yeah, that was a long time ago. Yeah.
Yep, 12 years. And we were there when he first fell in love with speed.
Since the movie's wrapped, I bought a car. I tuned it. I mean, I'm racing it all the time.
Just 4 years later, Paul had arrived in Hollywood but never forgot who he was or where he came from.
You know, I like to think that the way that I was raised, my family, I was raised in a religious home. You know, I always had a core group of friends, and, you know, not everyone's so fortunate, so I try to live life one day at a time, and I'm a go-with-the-flow kind of person.
Yes, he was, and I was lucky enough to see that Zen attitude firsthand on a number of occasions over the years. I remember sitting down with him in Brazil for Fast Five in 2011, and he was typical Paul, shoes off, very focused, and doing it for his fans.
How important is fan enthusiasm to the continuing success of this franchise?
It's everything.
Yeah.
I mean, without the fans turning out and seeing it, you know, it's just, we're not going to be making them anymore. At the end of the day, we're making movies. If you can't have fun doing that, then you should probably find another job.
Paul spent a lot of time in Canada, from filming in BC.
That was a good place to be for a few months. A snowmobiling on the weekend.
To Winnipeg.
My buddies love it. Coming from out of town, they don't want to leave.
And most recently, Montreal. E-Talk joined him on the set of Brick Mansions this past summer.
I think, you know, it's just, you know, run and have fun and be cool and just live it.
Up next, this is a man who gets Madge to work it.
She still finds the 2 hours, 6 days a week to work out.
Madonna's personal trainer, Tim Anderson, shows Venus and Fur actress Carly Street how to channel the superstar in a workout.
Zip it, snatch it, whack it, feel it, give it an arm.
The Goldbergs, all new tomorrow.
Cold, cough, and flu symptoms? Forget them. Get Benelin Extra Strength, the strength you want.
This is not Carol, and this is not Sean. When pain takes you away from who you are, trust Tylenol Extra Strength. It's tough on other pain like it is on headache pain. Tylenol Extra Strength. Get back to normal, whatever your normal is.
Only Virgin Mobile members get. Only Virgin Mobile members get sweet travel discounts and hot fashion deals from our awesome partners. Are you missing out? Virgin Mobile, it's better to be a member.
Rob Ford just can't catch a break. The embattled mayor attends a Buffalo Bills game in Toronto on Sunday and in true Ford fashion sits in another spectator's seat. Yep, musician Matt Mays is taking to Twitter outing the mayor. Ford's later spotted chowing on chicken wings and causing such a ruckus with fans wanting photos, he's escorted out by police during halftime.
From Broadway dancer to becoming one of Madonna's personal trainers, Tim Anderson knows how to whip a body into tip-top shape. And tonight, he's showing actress Carly Street how to work it in heels.
Madonna does a lot of performing in heels. The strength in heels class is an extension of that which incorporates core and lower body.
Tim says working out with Madonna is an inspiration, and not just because she pushes hard in the gym.
You imagine everything that she has going on, she still finds the 2 hours, 6 days a week to work out.
So who better to give a few pointers to Carly, who's starring in the Cannes stage production of Venus in Fur, which has Carly in some revealing outfits and very high heels.
These are the actual shoes. I have a little warm up before we go on stage. My Achilles are aching and my toes, and then I get on stage and I forget about it. And then I come off stage and promptly rip them off my feet. I'm gonna show Madonna how to work out.
We are going to do a few warm up moves. Lunge front and back. Now from here, let's extend to the back, hands on the waist and up. That would be a combination of hard and harder. Now to get to hardest, I'm gonna show you a move that actually this past week we were doing with Madonna in the gym. Touch the ground.
Oh. Oh God, this is seen on the World Wide Web.
Where's the understudy?
Maybe she just needs some more room to move.
Keeping inner thighs, core engaged. Uh-huh, you just got like a foot taller when you did that.
And how about a little runway?
Get it. You're ready to pose it out.
With star after star chopping off their locks, it's all about the pixie cut in Hollywood. So we head to Chavello to give one lucky girl the style of the season.
So a lot of celebrities have been cutting their hair short. Jennifer Lawrence, Pamela Anderson, Miley Cyrus, of course.
It's official. The pixie cut is a must-do for your new do.
All over Hollywood, celebrities are making drastic cuts to their hair. Are you ready to try this hot new trend?
I'm ready.
All right, let's get started.
With the first snip, there's no turning back. But rest assured, it's a hairstyle that will flatter any face.
I believe that there's a short haircut for every face. You can actually do a lot of shaping to complement a face shape with short hair. People want to see more structure and a little bit more tailoring in their haircuts. So short haircuts really fit the mood of like fashion and style right now. Nothing says I have a lot of confidence like a really short haircut.
And drum roll, please.
All right, are you ready to see your new shortcut?
I'm ready.
What do you think?
Oh, wow. I absolutely love it. Rihanna, she better look out.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi. I think that possibly maybe Hi. I'm falling for you.
Warm up someone's holiday.
Yes, there's a chance that I've fallen quite hard over you.
With a Tim Hortons coffee mug, Tim card, or take-home coffee.
Benelin Extra Strength Mucus and Phlegm has the strength to clear out mucus and phlegm. Try Benelin Extra Strength Mucus and Phlegm.
Like quitting smoking, that was hard. But with the help of Nicorette, you can quit. Nicorette helps relieve cravings plus withdrawal symptoms, shrinking them until you can finally quit for good. Nicorette, do something amazing.
Epic journey.
What is this place?
The desolation of Smaug.
ETOC, Travel New Zealand, and Air New Zealand want to send you to the home of the Hobbit trilogy in New Zealand. Enter at ETOC.ca and tune in starting December 9th for ETOC's Hobbit Week, counting down to the release of The Hobbit, The Desolation of Smaug, in theaters December 13th.
Ronnie Hawkins has rocked out with some of the biggest names in rock and roll, and in tonight's Bose Music Monday, he stops by for a little reminiscing.
When I was a little boy, I wanted to do backflips and do this and do that just to get attention.
And he's been grabbing attention for his rockabilly hits for close to 60 years. Affectionately known as The Hawk, Ronnie is considered one of the biggest rock and roll influences in Canada. He's worked with legends like Roy Orbison and hosted John Lennon and Yoko Ono at his home.
They're a powerful couple. I didn't know how powerful they were until they moved in. She could call anybody. Everybody was calling her. Ambassadors and movie giants and Princess Margaret.
He also nurtured Canadian talent like super producer David Foster.
Well, he learned how to chase those girls pretty good. He learned how to drive a bus. He was a good bus driver, David Foster was.
Clearly, the Order of Canada recipient has an eye for talent, and nowadays, he's a fan of the Biebs.
I think he's talented as can be. He's young, and he's got a little money, and he's got all them beautiful girls after him. I'd probably kill myself if I was in his position, but he seems to be handling it pretty good.
Now at 80 years young and after beating pancreatic cancer, Ronnie is still touring and performing, but he jokes that he still likes to take time for the ladies.
I did catch a couple last week. They were on them walkers, you know. But one of them said she did slow down just a little bit on purpose, just, but not much.
Music Monday is brought to you by Bose Quiet Comfort 20 noise-canceling headphones.
The Brick's famous Black Friday blowout is held over. 75% off all genuine leather sofas when you buy the matching love cedar chair. Get these sofas only $399. And these new exclusive sofas are 50% off. Black Friday is held over at The Brick.
At Subway restaurants, things are heating up with the Hunger Games Catching Fire promotion. Participate for your chance at thousands of our hottest prizes yet. Buy a drink and enter your code at Subway.com. You could even win free Subway subs for a year. And to ignite your taste buds, try the new creamy sriracha sauce made with a hint of garlic and spicy chili. Taste it on the sizzling sriracha steak melt. Heat things up and participate today. Subway, eat fresh.
Everyone's gonna love the gifts I found at HomeSense. Crystal, silver, jewels, and gold. For under $25 each.
And Sarah Bell. Plus, it's a kids' gift guide extravaganza with day two of our 10 days of giveaways. That's Tuesday on an all-new Maryland.
Welcome back. Well, that's it for me from the crash site. I've got to say, it's amazing how many people have stopped by, even in the short time that I've been here. We will continue to follow this story closely and keep you posted on the latest developments.
Thanks, Ben. Such a sad story. Well, thank you so much for joining us, and we will see you back here next time. Bye.